Hi everyone, welcome to today's lesson. We're going to be looking at negative drawing today, which is a fun approach to drawing, different to how we would normally start something, but the end result can be quite similar. So the general idea is that you basically tone your paper completely. Usually you'll work in something like charcoal, but you can do negative painting is something we could look at as well, where you have wet paint and you kind of erase back into the paint to produce the image. With this one, we're just going to be looking at charcoal. You can work in graphite as well, but charcoal is good because it's quite soft and doesn't tend to get too worked in to the image or into the paper of the tooth of the paper. It doesn't flatten out the tooth of the paper, so it allows you quite a lot of erasing. So we're going to be toning the paper with a mixture of this block charcoal. And I've got another soft 2B, slightly more expensive piece of charcoal. And then making our drawing using a kneadable eraser, piece of kneadable eraser, and a pointed kind of pen eraser for finer work. So it's kind of like a hard, if you've not seen them before, a sort of hard, see if I can get it to focus. Hard eraser, but kind of in the shape of a pen, so it's really good for this sort of work. And we'll also probably be using a little bit of kitchen towel, but you can also use like a sponge, a dry sponge as well, just for spreading the charcoal initially. So to get started, we'll get straight into it. Got my paper mounted here. I've got it on a canvas, but you can put it on a board. So we're just going to softly, not pushing too hard, a bit darker with this B charcoal. Smoothing it out with my kitchen towel. Just tighten that a little bit more. Once it's smoothed out, you can try to layer some more charcoal over it, depending on how dark you want your blacks to be. So this basically becomes the blacks in the image, the darker the image. You can keep adding layers of that. So we've got our tone blocked in, and we can now start kind of loosely erasing our shape into it. So what I'm going to be drawing, I've got a little reference here of I think it's a heron, kind of in profile, but it's got a dark background behind it. So generally, in this case, the heron has quite white feathers, and we've not really done anything with animals before, so it's kind of a nice change. just going to slide around here a little bit. The background in this drawing is pretty dark, and the heron is light over the top of it. So I'm just going to be kind of working the light of the heron into the image, and everything else remains dark. If I was working on a white piece of paper, I'd have to spend a lot of time kind of carefully turning everything around the heron. So this can be more efficient as a way of blocking in a drawing. But I'm going to work relatively similar to normal. Going to generally find the shape of the heron within this image. So similar to when you're drawing and you work loosely, I'm just lightly using this kneadable eraser to kind of explore the shape of the heron. So now I've got that roughed in, I can just start to kind of lightly remove the tone inside. I'm going to leave the beak because it's quite dark, the beak. But again, I don't want to remove the tone too quickly, because some of the heron's actually reasonably dark. There are some sort of shadows within it. So I'm going to just kind of progressively work back, and it's the same as when we're working dark over light. So you can see the form starting to emerge now. I'm being a lot more kind of confident with those areas of the drawing that I know are going to end up the brightest white. And I'm kind of working more softly in the areas that I know might end up in shadow. So there's a kind of a deeper shadow that comes through the back of the head here. Generally, the light direction is coming from the right-hand side.
And then we've also got some sort of reflected light in the back of the head here,
but a sort of core shadow
that runs down the inside just here.
We know that it's
pretty bright.
So you don't need to be super neat.
It's kind of inherently a kind of messier approach to drawing than you would typically use.
And once you've sort of established
the lighter sections of your drawing, you can now return to the charcoal. and kind of work back into it.
So you should then, kind of having not totally kind of used all your darks, you can go back in
and start to reassert some of the darker portions of the drawing. But everything should roughly be established.
Gives you some scope to create that
that range within the darks.
Also makes your lights look a bit punchier than they would otherwise.
Probably my one thing I would maybe do slightly differently if I was to start this again would be to not work the charcoal in quite so much into the paper. It does vary from paper to paper. Some papers are better at withstanding heavy charcoal erasing than others.
This paper didn't quite
have as much tolerance as I'd hoped for. But I managed to get that light enough that now that we're working back over in this manner, darker points in the herons as well, particularly in the beak.
So you can go through and re-emphasize those where they've been lost.
texture.
From this point onwards, pretty much everything that I'm looking for in the
image is established.
So it's more a case of messing around with it and sort of finding little details that I want to emphasize,
that you might want to emphasize in your own drawings. One last thing I might look for, kind of getting near the end of this one, just be some sort of texture at the edges of the birds, so start to suggest kind of little bits of
how certain feathers might fly up a little bit,
flap,
caught in the wind,
just to kind of
assert the texture slightly,
sort of positioning of the wings. Again, some little bits of
softer feathers.
Just at the edge here. Some finer lines crossing into
the shadowy part. And probably, I think I would leave it at that point. So as I say, something to watch out for that sort of a bit of an error on my part is going a bit too heavy. When I first blocked in the tone behind, I'd probably maybe try to do that a bit more softly. Possibly don't work in too much. I think that might have been one of my errors. And it does depend on the paper, so if you've got slightly better paper than I was using, it might withstand that level of working in and then still be able to erase out. But it really varies, and it's worth something worth experimenting with. But it's definitely a fun approach to drawing. Creates quite a loose effect, And if you're working with something that's predominantly dark, I definitely recommend it, because you're kind of starting at your average tone rather than having to work up to your average tone and work evenly kind of everywhere around to do so. So yeah, that's it pretty much. It's something we might look at in paint as well. So I might do that in coming weeks. I can do the same thing, but I'll go through it using washes and erasing wet paint. It's a little bit more forgiving than this, because your paper is more reluctant to erase than you can erase wet paint. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Hopefully it was interesting. As always, you can watch all our other videos on YouTube, or if you click the link through, you can sign up for tuition with myself and other tutors, one-on-one tuition online, so that any work that you do can be critiqued. But otherwise, I'll see you guys soon.